Hello dear students, now I am going to speak on the division of power between the state and the central government. In the Constituent Assembly, there was a heavy debate regarding the allotment of powers to the state governments and to the central government. If there is no power in the hand of the government, they would not be able to run the country systematically and with discipline. But the question came that in a federal system of government in India, who would be having what type of power, or what would be the extension of powers, and thereby several opinion came up. Some of them I am going to tell you now. There were some leaders in the Constituent Assembly demanded and argued in favor of having more and more strong power in the hand of the central government. Therefore, central government should be powerful than the state government. One of the person was very popular, you know the name, it's called Jawaharlal Nehru. Jawaharlal Nehru was in favor of making the central government very, very powerful. He wrote a letter to the president suggesting and demanding why central government should be made powerful, so that there should be tranquility, there would be law and order within the country, and country would be saved from the foreign invasions easily. Then draft commission, those who were making the draft regarding the power and proposals in the constitutions. This draft commissions said that the power of the country should be divided into three lists. One list is called Union List, another one will be called State List, and third one will be called Concurrent List. Now if you look at the board clearly, here I wrote Union List means there will be areas which should be taken care of by the central government. There are areas which would be taken up for the welfare of the state by the state government. But there are certain areas of development for the entire country which would be both taken care of by the central government as well as by the state government. That is called the Concurrent List. Now, if you study these three lists, you find out, first one is called Union List, means it is made in such a way that the central government should be made powerful. And the power of the central government also can be exercised by virtue of the Concurrent List over the states also. In this way, draft commission signaled that central should be made much more powerful. According to the Constitution, Article 356, it is an interesting article which goes in favor of the power of the central government, that if the governor of a state recommends to impose president's rule over a state, then the central government could exercise the power and make the state government inactive for a certain period of time. So by virtue of this Article 356, once again I like to tell you that there were leaders who were in favor of making the central government powerful, and these were their arguments, main arguments. Now on the other hand, there were some other leaders who favored that state government should be powerful. Let us see what do they say. To make state government powerful, those who argued, one was called K. Santanam from Madras. K. Santanam from Madras. This gentleman said that if center would be given more and more power, it might collapse or break down. Because always there is a limit of every work. So if more than the expected burden is given on the central government, then it might collapse. Therefore, much of the power should be given to each of the state government. Why? According to him, the state government knows the local welfare and requirement, and therefore they should be given power to develop their own region or their own state. How the center from Delhi would be able to know the local problem of a local area? So it is the local government who would know its need and would do the developmental work, and for that they should be given much power. A member from Orissa, his name is not here, this member proposed that too much work on the center would not be good. It would be burdensome for them, therefore the state should be made powerful in such a way that the state government would be able to bring development to their own areas. The development of the state, ultimately the development of the whole country. Therefore, state should be made much more powerful. Another idea came that why state should be made powerful was that if the central government was more powerful, then the central government would exercise power in such a way that the developmental work, welfare work, satisfaction for different regions and the states might be hampered. And as a result, who knows, in the future, the different provinces of the state would revolt against the excessive power of the central government. So states, different states might revolt against the government, central government, in future. My dear boys and girls, you have heard the allocation of power to the state government and the central government. Some were in favor of having more power for the central government, some were having opinion for more power in the state government. Now, what was the decision in the Constituent Assembly? What was the decision? Here it is. It is true that if the central government was not powerful or would not be powerful, then the question of safety of the country would be in danger. Safety of country would be in danger. And it would be fitting for the central government to think about the overall protection of the country. A state government would think about the protection of its own area and the region, whereas the central government would think about the overall development, overall protection, overall welfare of the whole country. Therefore, central government should be made powerful than the state government. To this effect, Baba Ambedkar said that he was in favor of more power in the central government. Side by side from the United Province, another popular leader was called Balakrishnan from United Province. He also proposed that central government should be made more powerful than the states. From Mysore, another popular leader from Mysore, his name you want to know. Yes, he was called Ramaswamy. Ramaswamy. He also demanded that central government and its power should be much more than the state government. I need not prolong the list, but conclusion is this. Ultimately, it was decided in the Constituent Assembly that central government should have more power than the state government. And in this way, the decision was decided in favor of the central government. Thank you very much.